Hello, my name is Sarah Stansberry, and I'm an intern at Geisinger. This presentation was developed by Amy Knight Johnson, a clinical genomics scientist at Invitae, and will provide a brief introduction to the types of genetic variants and the nomenclature used to describe them. A variant is a change to the nucleotide sequence at a particular position in the genome, compared to the genome assembly or genome build being used by a laboratory performing sequencing as a reference. Please refer to our Introduction to Genome Assemblies and Transcript video for more information about reference genomes. Variation in the genomic sequence can occur anywhere in the genome, including within or around genes, or in non-coding regions of the genome. For most clinical testing, laboratories are focused mainly on variants identified in or around the coding sequences of genes. A variant can be described based on its position in the genome or based on its position within a specific gene. This example shows how a variant can be described based on its position within the genome. CHR17 indicates that this variant is present on chromosome number 17. The HG19 notation in parentheses refers to the genome assembly being used as a reference when describing this particular variant. The lowercase g indicates the coordinates provided refer to a position in the genome rather than a position within a specific gene. In this example, at nucleotide position 7,578,263 on chromosome 17 in genome assembly HG19, the reference nucleotide is a G, and a variant is present where the G, or guanine, nucleotide has been substituted for an A, or adenine, nucleotide. The same variant shown in the last slide can also be described based on its position within or around a specific gene. In the example used on the last slide, the variant on chromosome 17 occurs within the coding region of a gene called TP53. This example shows how the same variant can be described based on its position within the TP53 gene. NM_000546.4 indicates the TP53 transcript being used as a reference in this case. Please refer to our Introduction to Genome Assemblies and Transcript video for more information about transcripts. Variant naming can vary depending on the transcript being used, so it is important to specify a transcript for any variant. The gene name that this variant is being named in relation to is noted in parentheses. In this case, it is the TP53 gene. Finally, the numbers and letters at the end show that in the TP53 transcript being used as a reference sequence, at nucleotide position 586 in the coding region of TP53, the reference nucleotide is a C, and a variant is present, where the C, or cytosine, nucleotide has been substituted for a T, or thymine, nucleotide. You may have noticed that when describing this variant on genomic coordinate level, we said this variant was a G to A change. However, on the gene level, the variant is called a C to T change, even though it is the same variant in both cases. This difference is due to variation in the DNA strand that the variant can be read from. Genomic coordinates always refer to the nucleotide sequence on the forward DNA strand. The coding regions of genes can have different orientations within the genome on the forward or reverse strands. So different genes may be read using either the forward or reverse DNA strand as a reference. In this case, at this position in the genome on the forward strand, the reference nucleotide is a G, and in the variant, it is changed to an A on this strand. At the same position on the reverse strand, the reference nucleotide is a C, which is complementary to the G nucleotide on the forward strand. On the reverse strand, the variant is a substitution of the C to a T, which is complementary to the variant A nucleotide on the forward strand. In reports containing genetic testing results, you may not always see a variant written out in the way it is shown here with the transcript number, gene name, and variant description all written together. The components of the variant name may be broken up and presented separately within the report. So the gene and transcript number may be described separately from the variant name, which may be written alone as C.586C to T. This diagram illustrates the structure of a fictitious 2-exon gene to illustrate how nucleotides are numbered within a gene. The coding sequence of the gene is contained within the exons of the gene, which are separated by non-coding intronic regions. Transcription will start upstream of exon 1 in the region called the 5' untranslated region, or UTR, and will end in the 3' UTR region. After transcription, the intronic sequence will be spliced out. When the resulting RNA molecule is translated into a protein, Translation starts at the ATG sequence in exon 1, which is the first 3-nucleotide codon in the gene and encodes a methionine amino acid. Translation ends at the first stop codon sequence that occurs within the coding region. The numbering of nucleotide positions within the gene is all relative to the ATG start site. The A nucleotide in the ATG's translation start site in exon 1 is the first nucleotide, named C.1. Starting from C.1, nucleotides are then numbered in order until the end of the first exon. In this example, there are 36 nucleotides in exon 1, so the last nucleotide in this exon will be called C.36. For the exon 2, the nucleotide numbering follows on from the last nucleotide in exon 1. So in this case, the first nucleotide in exon 2 is called C.37. In this example, exon 2 also has 36 nucleotides, including the stop codon. So the last coding nucleotide in the gene is numbered C.72. Variants within the intron are described relative to their distance from the closest exon. For example, C.36 plus 10 describes a variance in intron 1, 10 nucleotides downstream of the end of exon 1, which is named C.36. C.37 minus 10 describes a variant in intron 1, 10 nucleotides upstream of the beginning of exon 2, which is named C.37. Nucleotide positions in the 5' UTR are named backwards from the C.1 translation start site. So a nucleotide that is 10 nucleotides upstream of the C.1 nucleotide position in exon 1 would be called C.-10. Nucleotide positions in the 3' UTR are named relative to the stop codon using an asterisk notation. A nucleotide that is 10 nucleotides downstream of the C.72 nucleotide position in exon 2 would be called C.*10. Once the nucleotide position that a variant occurs at has been identified, the variant is named. This slide shows some examples of common variant types, including nucleotide substitutions, deletions, duplications, and insertions. For substitutions, one nucleotide in the sequence is substituted for another without increasing or decreasing the total number of nucleotides in the sequence of the gene. This is denoted by showing the reference nucleotide, in this case a C, at position C.349, followed by the variant nucleotide, in this case a T. For deletions and duplications, the variant nomenclature indicates the size of the deletion or duplication by showing the first and last nucleotide of the region that was deleted or duplicated. For insertions of additional nucleotides within a gene, the nucleotides that have been inserted are listed, in addition to the nucleotide position in the gene that occurs directly upstream of where the insertion occurs. The overall impact of a variant on a gene typically depends on how that variant affects the resulting protein after translation. For coding regions within a gene, each variant named at the nucleotide level can also be named at the protein level. Nucleotides are grouped into consecutive sets of three within the coding regions, called codons. The three nucleotides within each codon code for one amino acid that will be incorporated into the protein synthesized during translation. Protein level naming is denoted by a P dot at the beginning of the variant instead of nucleotide level naming, which is denoted by a C dot. The numbering in the protein level name corresponds to the amino acid residue in the protein that is impacted by the underlying nucleotide level change. This slide shows some example variants in the TP53 gene and how the nomenclature describes the predicted effect of the variant on a protein. In the first example, the C to T nucleotide substitution at C.586 leads to the creation of a stop codon at the corresponding amino acid residue in the protein 196. This is called a nonsense variant. The new premature stop codon is denoted by the asterisk. This variant would be predicted to lead to premature truncation of the TP53 protein during translation. In the second variant example, four nucleotides are deleted, which leads to a shift in the 3-nucleotide reading frame for translation, where every 3 consecutive nucleotides are translated into an amino acid in the protein. The first amino acid residue in the protein affected by this deletion is the isoleucine at amino acid position 162. This isoleucine is converted to a threonine in the protein due to the shifting of the reading frame caused by the deletion. Shifting the reading frame also leads to the creation of a premature stop codon downstream of the deletion. In this example, the new premature stop codon occurs 7 amino acids downstream of where the deletion occurs, starting from the isoleucine amino acid at position 162. The new premature stop codon is again denoted by an asterisk, and the number after the asterisk denotes how far downstream this occurs in the protein. In the next example, three nucleotides within TP53 are duplicated, from nucleotide 586 to 588. As the number of nucleotides duplicated is a multiple of 3, this duplication does not disrupt the reading frame during translation. This duplication of 3 nucleotides results in the duplication of 1 amino acid residue on the protein level in arginine and residue number 196. The fourth example in this slide shows a substitution at the nucleotide level of an A to a C nucleotide at position C.701. On the protein level, this changes the amino acid that the 3 nucleotide codon encodes for at amino acid residue 234 from a tyrosine to a cytosine. This sequence change leads to the substitution of a single amino acid in the protein and is called a missense or non-synonymous variant. The fifth example in this slide shows a substitution at the nucleotide level of a G to an A nucleotide at position C.576. Due to redundancy in the genetic code, although the nucleotide sequence has changed, the amino acid encoded for by the codon at this position in the gene remains the same, a glutamine. The prediction of no change to the amino acid code associated with the C.576 G to A variant is denoted on the protein level by the equal symbol after the amino acid residue. The final example shows a variant within the intron, a C to G substitution that occurs 5 nucleotides upstream of the C.560 nucleotide. Variants in the intron may or may not have an impact on the protein that is synthesized during translation by impacting processes such as splicing. However, the effect of intronic variants on the protein cannot easily be predicted by knowing the variant location and substitution alone. Therefore, on the protein level, an intronic variant is usually described simply as P. indicating that the effect of the variant on the protein is unknown. I hope this has been a useful introduction to different types of sequence variants and nomenclature. Please visit www.clinicalgenome.org for additional educational resources and to learn more about ClinGen initiatives. Our funding sources are listed at the bottom. Please feel free to contact ClinGen by email at clingen@clinicalgenome.org with questions or feedback. Thank you.